But I'm not concerned about canceling service. I'm concerned about somebody having the heat on in this building. Anybody else? How many are freezing to death right where you're at? Look at this. Is that all? Because y'all are bundled really tight. It just looks to me. How many have gloves on right now? Raise your hand. Yeah, well, okay. Maybe it's, I'm overreacting. Anyway, good evening. Sounds like our attendance is 41. Good evening. Yeah, all right, there we are. Just a couple of things real quick before I get on this list that I'm going to go through here. One is that next Sunday morning, there's a group of young people who are going to be in Dallas as part of the Challenge Youth Conference. If that group of young people go into Dallas and Cabot and Mr. Wallace, if you'd raise your hand so we can see who all is going to be gone. Raise your hand real high. Get a good crop of some other adults. Good, good. So they'll be gone in Dallas. My family will be in Conway for YOU, and we've only been there once. And this year, they called and just said, we need a speaker, nobody else will do it. And I said, I don't do you stuff, but we're going to back up the pictures. Way too, yeah, just go back. Yeah, way back, all the way to the very beginning. Yeah, that's the very beginning. We'll get to the pictures in a second. Yeah, okay, there's a song. Let's sing again, shall we? No, so anyway, that's where I'll be back Sunday night. But for Sunday morning, Andrew Hicks will be back. I love that young man, and the other guy, Garrison, who was here before. I just want to encourage him every time I have a chance and let you see what some good products that CRA is producing. CRC and Harding are working on perfecting. But CRA started the process. Actually, I guess the parents did. But I'm going to give CRA some credit and some stuff there. They're great young people, and you'll enjoy hearing him. Every year, for my own sake, but also for the sake of the church, I go back and I review the whole year before. I think sometimes we have tunnel vision and we forget where we've come from, what we've done, the things that we've done. It presented a big problem this year because you got to go back to remember stuff you weren't here for. It's kind of hard to do, to remember stuff that never happened to you. And so I felt almost like I was living somebody else's life. But, you know, with a good secretary that is here, and you do have the best secretary in the entire brotherhood. I just want you to know that. Good. That's what you're supposed to. On cue, $5 to each of you. She keeps all those bulletins together. And I said, can you show me last year? She had them in a pile, just perfectly organized in a pile, in a binder. And I went through there. And I want you to see what you as a family experienced. And then we're going to look ahead at this year, at what you, Lord willing, will experience as a church. There's something valuable about this. There's no open Bible, so there's no text. So for those, it's not a sermon, okay? So it's just a review, and I want you to see it, and I want you to experience it, and ooh and ah over the people that you'd forgotten, things that have happened. So in January of last year, and maybe even going back into December before, Sailor Bryn Martin was born. Now here's the picture, there you go. Oh, now that's sweet, okay. Jackson Brewer was baptized. This is January. They went to the Challenge Youth Conference in Dallas. Was that the first time or second? Second time, so this will be third. Okay, so they went for the second time, and I want you to see the youth group being active and just see some of these. I won't say everything the youth group did, every devotional, but I want you to see some things that happened. So they went to the Dallas Challenge Youth Conference, had a great time. There was a father-daughter banquet, which I think they're going to do again this year, but I've never been part of a church that did that. I think Charlotte does that, and that's an amazing thing. And there you see some pictures from the father. You can't go wrong getting dads and daughters together doing anything. I love that. That was a neat thing. Karen Gray was baptized. We can all rejoice with that. There she is. She looks like Ginger Z, doesn't she? Don't you think? Weather people? Yeah, okay, so it's not just me. She looks sort of like a red-headed Ginger Z. I don't know why I say that, but anyway, she was baptized a year ago. Jim and Ina Brown placed membership, and the church has never been the same again. What colorful characters they are. Haddon Lieblong was baptized. I believe we have a picture of that. And that, sometime in late January, was when Kerry announced that he was resigning from Valley View. I don't know exactly the date, but it was in late January. As the calendar rolled around to February, Don Coker resigned as a deacon for health reasons. Two different ministers came to look at the associate position. Now, at this time, you just found out you're going to have to replace the pulpit, and I think that just kind of evaporated. So those two guys came, they tried out, I think everybody was fine with them, but the focus then turned to the pulpit, and these guys were just kind of, I don't know what happened to them, but anyway, they're not here. I haven't seen them. If they're here, they're hiding in the office very well. So that just kind of, the focus shifted. The youth group went to the Center Hill Youth Rally. I saw them there, and we were at the same spot. A Sweethearts Banquet. I'm not sure what all's involved in that, but in February you did the Sweethearts Banquet, and I love that idea. I don't know what that's about, but I think it's cool, and you put it in the bulletin, right? Men's Cook-Off on the 20th of February, and here were the winners. Wesley Rothy won first in four categories. Was anybody else cooking? You got to be kidding me. What? It just doesn't matter if he's still okay. In side dish, soup, dessert, and bread, he whipped everybody. Y'all ought to be embarrassed. But Kerry Williams also won Grand Master Chef for exotic spam meals. That makes me want to hurl. You can't do anything with spam to make it edible. Anyway, no wonder he didn't compete. Mission Sunday on the 21st of February with Bill Richardson coming. A collection was taken up of $13,283 for missions, and that was in February. Then came the Ladies' Day with the theme Fill My Cup with Diane Burton, and I love it when churches do Ladies' Days. It still looks like it was a good one. Angela Tate placed membership. David Counts was baptized on a Sunday night, grandson of Harold Harvey, and Colby Joel Caraway was born to the Caraways. And so all in February, almost a year now. It's hard to believe that for those of you who watch that, I'm sure, to think already a year. March rolls around, Ethan Nix was baptized. Spencer and Melissa celebrated 21 years, but you didn't know that. We weren't here. I just want to throw that in because I've been married 21 years. Not the 50, but it's just a matter of time. 29 more years. Wow. That's quite a feat, 50 years. All right. Wedding of Mallory Sluder and Heath Yarborough. There's a good picture of it. Good, beautiful picture. And they're here tonight. I saw them earlier. Potluck honoring the Williams family before they departed. You had a potluck to celebrate that, as is right. The Leaderettes and Ladies' Tea was on the 13th. I think that's a cool idea. An egg hunt apparently is an annual thing here. Lads to Leaders Potluck. I understand it's pretty serious business, too. Kathleen Gunn and Kale Quinn placed membership, and Layla Nix was born. I don't know if that picture's up there. Added to the Nix family. All that in March. Rolls around to April, and Bobby Montgomery, the first intern, I guess you'd call it intern of preaching, that Valley View had, finger food potluck to honor him as he was going out into, I believe, Illinois, where he's preaching now. Lonnie Jones came to speak. He came for the Youth and Family Weekend. I'm a huge Lonnie Jones fan. It's full of stories that I'm just not sure are all true. But that guy has experienced everything. And anytime you get a chance to talk to him or hear him speak, you need to take advantage of that. CRA Chorus came on the 17th and made a presentation here. And Adeline Walton entered the world. And the only baby girl who likes me. She smiles when I'm around her or even falls asleep, and I think she's adorable. She was born in April. May rolled around, and you had this graduation ceremony, right? A banquet for the graduates. Hannah Hudson and Ethan Johns and Dakota Kincaid and Aaron Poppleton, who looks like an Indian there. And I told her that this morning. She didn't understand it, but it looks like it to me. Elizabeth Ramsey, Haley Robinson, and Adam Stidman. So that's a huge group of people to lose at one time, as far as going off to college or whatever. Anyway, it was a good time to experience, according to all the bulletin reports from different people. I came to speak on Mother's Day, May 8th, which is a weird thing to think about. Ted Knight spoke on May 11th, and you had an outdoor worship service in that pavilion on that evening, and that was May 11th, and still people talk about that. Hazel Golden was born. A church has a new Hazel, and every church, as I've said, has to have one. And you have the cutest one in the country right there you see on that picture, born May 19th. The youth led the worship service on the 22nd of that month, and then the summer interns arrived. Madison Thornton, think she's from Boonville, Mississippi. I know that Thornton name from preachers from way beyond. Parker Wallace, I think, from Nashville, and they came in. Parker's coming back this year. A zoo trip on the 28th, apparently a big deal, and a lot of people went. And then Lyndall and Norma Turner celebrated their 50th anniversary on the 29th. Either this means they're really faithful elders or all the elders here are old. I don't know what that means. Anyway, June is one of the things that even in Canada I heard about because Paul Wallace would come around selling some supplies and tell me all about the canoe trip from the 5th to the 7th and beg me to come on that just to, I don't know, just for fun or maybe to drown me, I'm not sure. But that was, I look forward to that in June if I get a chance to go on that. Vacation Bible School. The big deal of Noah this year and the infamous story of the bird that kept going around and around and around and around and around. But I look forward to, as everybody else mentions, Daniel Rickman's going to do something great, you know, him and somebody else. They're going to do some kind of like hologram of a person or something this year. I keep hearing that. So I look forward to seeing that. Vacation Bible School is obviously a big deal, the 12th and the 15th. Red Hubble was baptized. The youth group went to Uplift, and at Uplift, Caitlin Jackson, Riley Smith, and Caleb Hooten were all baptized. Great experience at Harding. And George Williams passed away, one of the losses in the year for members. As the summer wore on in the month of July, GW and Fran Allison placed membership. Is GW here tonight? No. Everybody knows them, though, and I appreciate preaching at a place where you have that kind of an experienced man and a preacher's wife here. And so they are here as members, and we're grateful. We're richer for it. Valley View Youth Camp happened from the 4th to the 8th, and there at that camp is baptisms of Mason Morrow and Amber Thomas. So a good camp experience. Cade Holcomb was baptized on the 13th. One event we came to before we actually were here was the family water day on the 23rd, that giant weird water thing that Paul puts together. And I looked at that and I thought, somebody's going to die on that thing. But so far, no reported injuries, I don't think. Wilderness Trek, Cabot and Terry and some others took them out to Colorado for that. Great experience on the 23rd. Joe and Carlene Brewer placed membership on the 24th. And the last day of July at the Fowler Center, you had the Exaltation singing again, an annual event that draws a lot of people, and look forward to that again in July at the Fowler Center. Heat continues, August rolls in, and Tools for School happens again, where you provide those backpacks, which we'll talk about some more of that here in a minute. The Mother-Daughter Devotional, which I've never heard of that, I think that's a great idea, happened on August 2nd. Youth lock-ins took place. That's the one thing that I think youth ministers are insane for, having lock-ins, but I'm glad Cabot's the one doing that. Back to School Bash, a great thing for everybody, not just here, but in Northeast Arkansas and Southeast Missouri. That is a huge deal for all the youth groups to be able to come to as school's about to start again. So do not underestimate the value of that, not just for you, but for the churches of the area. It's almost a service project. It's a great thing, and it was good this year. The Furbies arrived on the 15th, and Parents Night Out took place right after that. I think Charlotte's behind that, and I think she's insane for that too. But that's kind of the staff you've got here. September, or August into September, Charles Randall passed away. A sad thing for the church. New members, Derek, Celia, Dre, Lindsay, Jason, Lisa, Evan, and Corbin Paxton placed membership here. Heritage Banquet took place on a Thursday night on the 8th. And get this one, Charlie Pride. Yeah, I got to go hear him with the Pears and Spares. Where does that name come from? That's a little weird name, Pears and Spares. Anyway, they let me go on that trip with them. I guess I'm a pear, so that's okay. So, and Charlie Pride was excellent. New members to place become part of Valley View were Brandon and Ashley Holt and John Daphne and Clay Hearn. So, I had some great new people at that time. The Well started up again with the college group. Special contribution for the relief fund from flooding in Louisiana. The church took up $27,070 on that Sunday. Marriage Enrichment Weekend on the 14th for 27 couples from Valley View. By all accounts of those people who went, it's one of the most important things that happened here. And if you're not a married person or you're not a person who really realizes the value of that, talk to one of those people, because that must have been a really, really encouraging thing for them. The youth breakfast started again on the 21st. We tailgated out of the ASU on the 24th. And then Corbin Coates was born on the 30th. October. Dirk Smith of the Eastern European Mission spoke here. Then the Family Fun Day, and I had to miss it, but I heard there was some great food on that day on the 9th. Rhonda Phillips placed membership on the 9th. The youth group went to Pumpkin Hollow. Ariane Lee Rickman was born on the 14th. Fried Hardeman Chorus was here on the 15th and 16th, did a tremendous, I'll never forget the songs they sang. Trunk or Treating on the 31st, and new members, Jesse and Jessica Stevens and Mitchell and Martha Fitz became members at the end of October. Then we rolled around to November. The family retreat that's held every year at Wildwood was held again. Pack-a-Sack was a great effort on the 19th of November. Hannah Stidman and Kenneth Curtis got married on that same day, the 19th. And new members, Tyler and Jonna Long and Nate and Elizabeth and Annie and Rhett and Cole Watson. They have been a blessing to this church, these new members here. December comes around and it gets a little bit strange as the holidays roll in. PJ's with Santa on the 2nd. A holiday potluck where we delivered to our shut-ins on the 4th. Christmas caroling on the 11th, the youth Christmas party, tremendous neat thing on the 11th, and then new members Seth and Jordan and Charlotte Prater became members at the end of the year. All along the way, there's some normal everyday things, not every day, but every week, or normal routine things, that sometimes you look in the bulletin, you see the same picture, this thing's meeting every week, and you have a tendency to overlook it because it's there every time. But the routine and the normal stuff that happens on a regular basis is incredibly important. Small groups still met. It's kind of disorganized at the moment. Ladies' Bible study went on. The lunch bunch that was here a lot, and they continued to meet every week. They had elders and some other members join them in doing visitation on Tuesdays. You don't see that unless you're visited that day, but I want you to know that is the life heartbeat of this church, is that kind of visitation. M&M teams, Children's Bible Hour, Pairs and Spares, prayer meeting every Tuesday, Lilia's Place, Sunday afternoon singings that you'll hear as you walk in the auditorium, visitation ministry, foster children for Christmas, and the generosity that was shown toward them and the children's home. This church is a giving church. This church looks for opportunities to help people who can legitimately use the help. That's something to commend. That all happened in the year 2016. Sometimes when you just take pieces at a time, you don't realize what all takes place, but you were busy. There were opportunities afforded you, if you wanted to take advantage of them, to exercise your faith in a number of ways. I hope as the new year comes and as it unfolds month by month that you'll also have that opportunity this year. Let me just tell you a couple of things and then we'll quit. At the end of January, on the 28th and 29th, I hate asking for Saturdays from people. I hate it because I know how precious they are to you. But that Saturday night, I'm asking Devin Swindle from Harding to come down. And one of our themes for the year is making sure we know there's a reason for what we do. We'll be having lessons on instrumental music. We'll be having lessons on male spiritual leadership, lessons on worship and the Lord's Supper, and those things that we take for granted a lot and maybe don't talk about as concentratedly as we need to. We'll have those every once in a while. They'll be announced before they're presented. But in this particular one, there's a reason why we believe Scripture is important, and we believe it's valid. We believe it's relevant. Even the Old Testament. So Devin Swindle's going to come down on a Saturday night, the 28th of January. We're going to have one session. We're going to have barbecue in between, and we'll have another session on that night. 45 minutes, eat 45 minutes. He's going to demonstrate for us how the Old Testament is still very much relevant to New Testament people. Do you know how hard it is to get people to come out on a Saturday night to talk about the Old Testament? It's going to be very difficult. It's going to be we're not going to meet in here. We're going to meet out there in the fellowship room out there. Next Sunday night, if all goes well, we are going to actually, I'm going to interview Devin, and you're going to see Devin up on this screen. We're going to interview him, and he's going to tell you why you should show up. I'm hoping we have 100, 150 people, and we're just going to enjoy a study of the Old Testament, why it's relevant. That Sunday morning, he'll continue that topic, and that will be done. We won't have a potluck or anything, but Devin Swindle will be here January 28, 29. February 19th, on a Sunday night, we're going to start about 4 o'clock, and it's going to be a youth emphasis worship. Theatron will be here. They'll do some skits with our young people. We'll have a special song leader here who does the youth songs a little bit. He's going to lead the young people. Now, I'm saying it's a youth emphasis. I don't say you older folks stay home. I want you to come. I want you to be part of that. Hear the energy these young people are going to sing. Watch the skits and go, I never did that when I was growing up. I know. But it's not worship. It's just entertainment. Theatron's going to do that. And Michael Meredith will present the lesson that night geared toward young people. And then afterwards, we'll have some pizza. But it's just something for our young people to get together on a Sunday night. We're asking young people from the area to come in and join us on that time. Saturday morning, Jam met, Jonesboro Area Ministries. And what I really like, this group of guys met, and what they decided to do is we want to do a service project that actually reaches people. And we want to actually meet a need and do something that lets Jonesboro know we're concerned about Jonesboro. What are some things we can do? We love Pack-a-Sack, and we're going to continue that. We're going to do the backpack and all that. But what can we do in the first quarter of the year where our members will have an opportunity? You don't have to, but you're going to have a chance to serve our community. How can we do that? It's got to be inside because it's freezing cold, right? So what are you going to do? We decided we're going to call and arrange this. I'll let you know when the dates will be. We're going to go down to the ICU and the surgery units down there at St. Bernard's and also at NEA. We're going to cook a meal here. We're going to take it down there. We're going to actually serve people in the hospitals while they're waiting in the ICU or their families are waiting in surgery or whatever. And we're going to be out there in an area they let us go to, and we're going to serve meals to them. And we're going to clean up afterwards. And we're just going to let those people who know, there's some of them there, you know, they got loved ones who they're really concerned about. You don't have to go buy a meal. There's a meal right here provided for you by the Valley View Church of Christ. Is that not a great idea? You know, if you've ever been in the hospital waiting, it's the worst kind of waiting there is in the world. So why not have somebody there meeting some kind of small need instead of putting quarters in a machine to get some weird kind of sandwich or going down and buying the cardboard hamburger, right, for $18 or whatever it is. Let's serve them this way. So that's what Jam decided to do, and I think it's a great idea. We'll be letting you know those details and dates. We will do another ministry intern. You know this guy, Jonathan Godsey, who was here as a youth intern a couple summers ago, three summers ago. How many? Two summers ago. He doesn't want to do youth ministry. He watched Cabot and said, I don't want to be like Cabot. He looked at me and said, I want to be like him. Ah, that's right. That's the kind of guy we're looking for. And so he decided, I want to preach, and he just wants to mentor preaching and do just like you did with Bobby for last year. So in May, after he graduates Harding, he's coming to Jonesboro, and he's going to stay here up to a year, year and a half, whatever it is. He won't be here that long. You ever heard him speak? You know he'll be snatched up by somebody before too long. But he's going to have some time with us, and I look forward to doing that and working with him and him teaching me some of these young things that are out there for preachers. Sermons from 1 Peter will continue till we're done, then we'll go into James. Sermons from Psalms are almost done. We'll go into Proverbs. We'll do some themes like there's a reason why we do what we do. I want our young people, before they go to college, to know why we do what we do. Why is it we believe what we believe in as simple a form as possible, but we have a conviction behind what we do. There's a reason, and it's not just our personal preference. It's not just because our elders decide that's what we want to do. It's because we believe that's what Scripture says, and we'll show that. So that is going to be stressed throughout the year, singing Sunday nights, teaching new songs, and having young people sing. We'll have a worship service on a Sunday morning. where we want to honor community helpers like the firemen. We'll have them come in as much as they can, much as they can show up, and serve them a catered meal afterwards. We want to do something like that just to let them know we appreciate them. Later in the year, we're going to do that with teachers of the area. At least give them the invitation to come and honor what they do. There'll be different things. I've just kind of touched on the first quarter. There are some other things in the works. Don't want to say much about those at this point. There's going to be, just like there's a youth emphasis Sunday night, there's going to be a seniors emphasis Sunday night. What speaker would the older folks like to come in and hear? What would be a good thing to do with our older members and let them know we appreciate them? What could we do? I'm going to get with Bernie on that and decide some things. These are just some things. And one of the most active groups, I said pairs and spares, I love what they do. They are constantly doing something that gets those older folks involved. And I want to honor what Bernie does because I think he's outstanding at staying on touch with that. And let's do that with other age groups and other emphases as well. There's a lot to be excited about being at Valley View. I think you're going to have opportunities. JAM has decided this. Every quarter, something is going to be made possible for you in some way to touch your community. All ages, different tasks, different roles. We're going to touch this community and let them know we're here. We are rebranding the congregation. We're going to have a new logo here pretty soon, and we're going to be known as the Church on the Hill. And the reason why we're going to be known as the Church on the Hill is that's what everybody calls us already. If you've ever noticed, and somebody says you're from Valley View Church of Christ, oh, you're the Church on the Hill. And you know what Jesus says about the city on a hill? It lets its light shine. It cannot be hidden. That's what we are about as a church. You're going to see a new logo. It's going to be on everything. We're going to get shirts. Make sure everybody has one. So when we get together and serve in the ICUs, we have the same shirt on that identifies us as that Church on the Hill that cares about our community. We want you to know who we are. We want you to know where we are. And we also want you to know what we believe and what makes us do what we do. That's what we want to do as a church. I hope you have a certain sense of pride about being in Valley View. I hope when we have new members come in here, they feel welcome and we make them feel welcome. And I hope if you're looking across the aisle on this side and you're seeing people you don't know yet, get to know them, know their names. Don't be content with coming to a church, well, yeah, they come sometime, I don't know who they are. I'm having a struggle memorizing names too, especially those I don't see as much. And so I go on one side and I try to go on the other side. I want to know the names. I want to be able to spot immediately whether somebody's a member or a visitor. I want to know because I want to know if they're a visitor. We're going to treat them a little extra warm as they come in here. But right now, sometimes I'll treat you extra warm and you're a member. I'm like, what am I worried about you for? Right? You're already here. But I want you to be proud of Valley View, and I want you to say, you know, this is where I go. This is my home church. This is what we do, and we're active doing things in the community, but we're also active in taking care of each other and our in-reach. And I want our Bible class teachers to put your all into it. You may have a great curriculum, and I want to challenge this. Some of you, we have our own written curriculum, and it's great, and I've heard people say, you can just pick that up and walk in the classroom and just read it to your kids. I want you to take even more pride in it than that, and I want you to be prepared that when they come in this class, you already know what your class is going to be. You've already read it, and you give it with some life. That when they come to our classes, we are prepared for them. We give them something that matters. You know what I believe? I believe when the college students come in here and they go to their college class, that's the only Bible they'll get this week. Let's be prepared for them to feed them when they're here. High school, junior high, that's likely some of the very, it's about all the Bible they're going to get mostly. Let's make sure when they come into that class, Cabot's going to make sure of this and the teachers he puts in there. When those kids come in here, that may be the only Bible they get, and that's going to be some good stuff for them to devour, and it makes them grow up and it matures them. And you adult class teachers, I know what a burden it is, and Terry's going, don't say anything too tough. It's hard enough to fill the classes. I know. You're going to take that class. You give it your all, and when they come in there, feed them. It's the only Bible they'll get this week. I assume that every time I teach a class. We've got to assume it. Pop psychology won't feed people. It won't nourish them. Little conversations will not give them enough to sustain them when the world attacks them the moment they reach the door and they go out to their cars. We have got to ground people in the truth. And I don't mean in a truth that we have these three words that's always true and this is the doctrine we believe. I'm saying we've got to teach how to think and how to be biblical. There is a reason that we get together here on Sundays and there's not an instrument here. And it's not because we can't afford one. There's a reason we don't use it. And I want you to know why we don't use it. And I want our young people to be able to go out there and not condemn people and not judge people to hell for using it, but letting them know there's a good reason we don't use it. And they're going to find that out in Bible classes and the sermons this year. I want you to know there's a reason besides male chauvinist pigs as elders why we don't have women preachers. We have women in this church who can preach better than me. We do. The reason they don't preach is not because they're not spiritual people or smart people or able people. There's another reason, and I want you to know what that is, so that when you go out of here, you're not unarmed when you're facing somebody who thinks we're being male chauvinist and a bunch of men who just like to be dominating, right? There's a reason we do what we do, and that's the theme for the year. And if you'll hang with us all year, we're going to be talking about these things constantly in different ways, and you're going to hear it. And I hope you're going to hear it in a way that doesn't judge people, that doesn't condemn people, that doesn't make people feel bad, but simply lets you know there is a reason why we do it, and there's a good reason. There's a biblical reason we do what we do. And when you go out there and face other people, it's not a debate, it's not an argument, it's not a fight. It's a conviction. A conviction you hold that not only do you believe it, but you can discuss it in a civil way with people who think differently. That's my prayer for every Valley View member in 2017. That's the year ahead. If you're in for it, if that sounds like something you want to journey with us with, hop on board and let's go. If it's something you say, I don't want to be a participant, I just want to slip in here once in a while, that's not the Sunday night crowd. But if you were to say that, I'd say, come slip in on us anytime you, we want you here and we'll make you feel welcome. I hope sometimes you come into a bigger church and you get lost. You guys are a big church. You can be intimidating and people can get lost. Try your best, members, to think what it would be like if you lived in Jonesboro and you walked in here for the first time and you saw all these strange faces. Try to think what that would feel like and be as outgoing and as friendly as you can be to every person who walks in this door. Everybody deserves you to look them in the eye, shake their hand, and say, have a great day. They deserve that from us, and I pray that we'll do it. There's nobody in here that's not worthwhile for that. That's the story for Valley View this year. I pray that those plans come about, and if they don't, it's God leading us in a different direction. But this is what we'll be about in 2017, and I hope we have a membership that gets excited about that and wants to be part of that. If there's any response you need to make, not because of the plans we've got, just simply because the truth sinks in and just sinks in for a while and it takes a while to gel in there. And if it's gelled on you and you realize you need to respond to the truth tonight, we stand ready to receive you as a group of people who will call you family, pray for you, immerse you, or whatever it is that you need to do to be part of the family of God. And if that's something you need to do, now's the time to do it as we stand and sing.